Good afternoon, and thanks for joining us on Bobcat Update. I'm Cody Wilson.
And I'm Charlena McNeil. Coming up, the Bobcat football team is gearing up for the maroon and gold game on Saturday, but we begin with a potential bus strike on Texas State campus. Some of the bus drivers at Texas State might go on strike if they can't reach a deal with the company they work for. David Cornwell has more on this Bobcat Update.
Contract talks have apparently stalled between shuttle operators and Transdev, the company that runs the university's shuttle system. The bus drivers are represented by Amalgamated Transit Union Local 1091. The union is petitioning for higher wages.
The goal for the petition is to make sure that all operators have a living wage in order to take care of themselves and their families and able to afford health insurance for themselves and their families.
Transdev's contract offer has been turned down by the union voters. The offer included a pay raise of 25 cents after every year work, stopping around the $15 an hour mark. However, shuttle operators who have worked 6 years or more for the shuttle system would receive a stipend of $250 a year with no pay increase.
And that's their employees that's been there for 6 years, they don't deserve a wage increase, they just get them a little bonus. And that's really a slap in the face of those people that's worked there all those years.
Currently, the Bobcat shuttle operators earn $10.98 per hour when they're first hired, compared to UT's bus drivers getting $13.30 an hour. After 4 years of service, shuttle operators at UT will earn $20.38 per hour.
School bus drivers make around about almost $13 an hour starting in San Marcos. That's not the case with the employees driving the Bobcat shuttle buses. They make much less starting.
General Manager of Transdev at Texas State, Jack Besh, says a significant portion of the workforce is comprised of part-time students. The company believes the wages and benefits are in line with the types of service being provided. Union President Jay Wyatt says a third of the operators are students, a third are retirees, and a third are looking to make a career driving the shuttles.
The last resort is always called a strike vote. That's a last resort. We'll go back to the table again and try to get them to get off their position. That, quite naturally, we're going to do that. Most likely we'll call the NFL a mediator.
And if that step doesn't resolve the situation, a bus driver strike is possible. For Bobcat Update, I'm David Cornwell.
McDonald's will raise the hourly wages for some 90,000 workers. Beginning July 1st, starting wages at the fast food chain will be at least a full dollar an hour more than the legal minimum wage. All current employees will get the raise. The company will also let full and part-time employees accrue paid time off as long as they've worked there for a year. The only catch is the new rules only apply to 1,500 restaurants actually owned by the McDonald's Corporation. About 90% of all locations are franchisee owned.
Students from the Texas State NAACP chapter are trying to establish an African American Studies program on campus. Tyler Stevenson has the story.
Many students are surprised Texas State doesn't have an African American Studies program. NAACP President Stephen Rollins says creating one would benefit all students personally and professionally.
But we don't talk about African Americans in other fields such as arts, culture, political science, education, health. We don't get a full depth of it. So people don't get a full knowledge and understanding of what African American history actually is.
Rollins says the program's goal would be to educate students about Black history beyond just slavery and civil rights.
And in that, you, of course, get to apply to different fields in academia and be able to enhance your skills. So when you go to a job interview or whenever you do whatever it is that you want to do out there in the world, you're able to do it with confidence because you know about yourself.
NAACP Assistant Secretary Aaron Lewis says the program would help promote diversity.
I think it will help expand knowledge and it will bring more cultural awareness to students.
A budget for the proposed program hasn't been established yet. Lewis says the university doesn't necessarily have to hire new professors.
It's not up to NAACP to pick the faculty members, but there are a lot of teachers or professors that are here on this campus already that are willing and capable.
Before the NAACP submits an official proposal to the university, it wants to gain support from the student body.
Well, we have a proposal letter that we typed up, and we're trying to get the petition together to get maybe like 1,500 signatures so we can take it to them so we can show them like this is what the students want.
To sign the petition, follow Texas State NAACP on Twitter and click the link in the bio. If granted, Rollins says the program would take about a year to implement.
For Bobcat Update, I'm Tyler Stevenson.
A Texas DPS trooper is facing disciplinary action after posing for an Instagram picture with the rapper Snoop Dogg. Trooper Billy Spears was in uniform when the photo was taken with the rapper during Austin's South by Southwest Music Festival last month. Spears' attorney says the discipline over the photo is due to Snoop Dogg's criminal history that includes drug charges.
After graduating college, many people face debt. They have college loans that in some cases can take years to pay off. But one Massachusetts man found out he had a nearly 30-year-old debt that he knew nothing about. The man graduated from college in 1987 and paid off his loans, or so he thought. Just last month, he received a letter saying he still owes his university $500. The good news for him is no interest will be charged for the long-hidden debt. The man says it's ridiculous for the university to wait 28 years to try and collect the money. If you're a senior, chances are you're making plans to graduate in May. The university bookstore is an ideal location to find out what you need to know before the big day. The bookstore has what's called a senior send-off. Patricia Martinez has more in this Bobcat update.
The university bookstore does much more than sell textbooks and Bobcat gear. It is a one-stop shop for those graduating in May. Events like Senior Send-Off provide students with the resources they need for a stress-free graduation.
It's very helpful. They've had a lot of things here, such as commencement information, as well as you can buy your class rings here, take senior proofs, picture proofs, so it's been really beneficial and really helpful.
Students can purchase their caps and gowns at the bookstore and get commencement information, such as dates and dress code policies. Bookstore personnel can answer questions about the commencement ceremony.
We get all kinds of questions, where to park, how many family members can attend, what they're supposed to wear, do they have to wear, you know, like heels or pants, or, you know, I mean, there's just all kinds of questions.
Don't forget, the bookstore has everything you need if you're graduating in May, so stop by at any time to pick up some information packets. For Bobcat Update, I'm Patricia Martinez.
Woo! A terrorist group linked to Al-Qaeda is being blamed for an attack today on a college campus in Kenya that killed almost 150 people. The attack started in the early mornings and lasted almost 15 hours. A government spokesman says that four terrorists were killed during this attack. Some students were able to escape and hide. Despite Kenya's recent encounters with terrorist groups, this is the first time terrorists have attacked a university.
People in North Texas got a jolt out of bed this morning when an earthquake hit the Dallas area. The details are next.
At the San Marcos Activity Center, members have access to numerous programs, services, and general wellness classes throughout the week that include cycling, step classes, and several others. The Activity Center boasts a 2,000 square foot weight room, two full-size multi-purpose courts, three racquetball courts, a 1/8 mile indoor walking corridor which features the Walker's Gallery, a timely showcase of work by local artists, and a cardio training area. With its own 6-lane, 25-yard pool, members can utilize private swim lessons, aqua pump classes, or open swim hours. For those interested in recreational sports, the center offers multiple youth and adult leagues that consist of basketball, indoor soccer, and many more. The Activity Center offers off-the-court activities like the chess club for all ages looking for a mental workout. Members also have the perks of renting on-site ballrooms for private functions. The Activity Center is located at 501 East Hopkins and is open Monday through Saturday. For more information, call 512-393-8280.
President Denise Troth will be holding her annual Cat Chat Thursday, April 16th from 3 to 4 p.m. The event will be held in the J.C. Kellum Building in the PAR room on the 11th floor. Registration for the event is now closed. Students who have registered for the event are encouraged to discuss their concerns, such issues as enrollment caps, diversity, ongoing construction, parking, and bus traffic have been common themes in the past. For more information about how you can be involved in the future Cat Chat, visit the President's page on the Texas State website. The Springtown Shopping Center in San Marcos is now under new management, which means a renewed effort to lease the site to retailers. Aaron Pollack has more in this Bobcat update.
An Austin-based real estate company is renovating the center to make it more attractive for restaurants, entertainment, and more. The Endeavor Real Estate Group recently purchased the 18-acre site at the intersection of Springtown Way and Thorpe Lane, across from the big HEB. The location has been largely dormant since 2009, when Target, Bell's, and Penny's moved elsewhere in the city. Roberto Gangorga says he would like more things to do in San Marcos, and this new center could be that.
Different places like music and places that you just don't really find in San Marcos just for being such a small place. And it'll be nice to have other places to go and look at things.
Most of the retail space at the center is vacant. Radio Shack is still there, but its future is questionable since the company is up for sale. Laura Moss, a public relations student at Texas State, says she rarely goes to the center now because of the lack of stores.
Recently, the only times I ever go over there is around Halloween, when that's like the only Halloween store. They rent out that space, and that's the only time.
With all of these empty spots, Endeavor has endless possibilities on how to make Springtown Shopping Center the place to be in San Marcos. For Bobcat Update, I'm Erin Pollack.
This could be a positive sign about the U.S. economy. Most Americans purchased a vacation home last year compared to 2013. According to a report from the National Association of Realtors, it found 21% of all homes bought last year were vacation homes. That's the highest level of vacation homes purchased since 2003. Experts say popular vacation spots like the beach and mountains could use a boost, since they tend to have a slower economic recovery pace.
A recent Pew Research poll revealed that 59% of Americans believe the American tax system should be changed. But when it comes to how much taxpayers actually give to the government, the U.S. is well below the average among the developed nations that Pew surveyed. The study did not include the state and local taxes, which vary depending on where one lives. April 15th is the deadline for filing taxes. San Marcos is pushing for a way to divert more waste from the area landfills. Bobcat Update's Zach Bland has the story.
One of the San Marcos area landfills will be closing in November, so it's more important than ever that residents recycle their garbage. They can do so by getting involved in composting.
There are a lot of reasons to compost, but I think the biggest one that will get people involved is diverting things from the landfills and decreasing our carbon emissions and making our air better.
The city offers a master composting class to help residents. Composting is recycling organic materials by letting them decompose naturally. The compost that is produced has many uses.
You're not using chemicals. You use chemicals on your garden. Those chemicals run off, or they just destroy the ecosystems in the soil. So you're supporting that ecosystem.
Programs like Dropping Off Brush and Bobcat Blend provide recycling alternatives. A lot of waste is being gathered, including paper packing materials and cardboard. But the city is hoping more people get involved.
The city of San Marcos is doing curbside composting, so that gives you the ability to contribute to composting without having to do any kind of backbreaking work.
The curbside pickup will add yet another outlet for San Marcos residents to dispose of their renewable trash easily. For Bobcat Update, I'm Zach Bland.
An earthquake struck North Texas this morning that could be felt in Irving and Las Colinas. The U.S. Geological Survey confirmed that 2.7 magnitude earthquake happened at 5:38 a.m. There is an identified fault line that runs right through Irving and into Dallas. The fault is about 2 miles in length and 3 to 5 miles deep. Many believe the former Texas Stadium implosion or gas drilling could be to blame for a recent series of earthquakes in North Texas, but SMU seismologists say they just don't know yet. No damage from today's earthquake has been reported.
Bike repairs can be expensive, but Texas State provides an alternative that students may not know about. Jose Plaza has more with this Bobcat Update.
As the quad fills with students moving to and from classes, Peter Voigt and David Ross set up their equipment. A line of various types of bicycles and tools surround them. Voigt and Ross come with one goal in mind: letting students and faculty know about the Bike Cave.
We have a very active social media campaign. We'll also flyer in the approved poster boards on campus, and we are in the quad.
Funded by Transportation Services, the Bike Cave assists students by making repairs, often for free, while teaching them proper bicycle maintenance and how they can do it themselves.
Some people, they don't know. Like, no one showed them, and I've been showed everything. So I'm just trying to spread my knowledge to other people.
The main shop, in room 100 of the Colorado building, is at a convenient location for many Bobcats. Workers and volunteers at the Bike Cave are happy to help their fellow students with bicycle repairs. Don't own a bike? No problem. You can purchase one from the Bike Cave's recycled stock, a collection of bicycles that have been abandoned but are still guaranteed to get you around campus.
I could take it to a bike shop, leave it for a week, pay them like 50, 60 bucks, and then not learn anything. Or I could take it there, have them show me how to fix it while they fix it, and do it for free.
The Bike Cave also provides a wealth of information for students who are new to biking. For example, you can learn on how to register your bike with the University Police Department. Having the bike on file can be very helpful in case it's ever stolen. For Bobcat Update, I'm Josue Plaza.
Up next, the Bobcat football team is wrapping up spring practice. We'll preview Saturday's maroon and gold game.
My name is Laura Horner. I'm the Park Operations Trainee here at Guadalupe River State Park in Honey Creek State Natural Area. Guadalupe River State Park is in close proximity to the San Antonio and Austin major metropolitan areas. The main attraction for guests is the Guadalupe River, which is behind me. We offer over 5 miles of hiking and biking and equestrian trails. We have camping, we do public hunts, nature hikes. We have an interpretive discovery center here in the park, and we offer programs, friendly staff, opportunities just to enjoy life outside because life's better outside.
For more information about Guadalupe River State Park and the Texas Parks and Wildlife Organization, visit their website at www.tpwd.state.texas.us. And remember, life is better outside.
Spring practice is well underway at Bobcat Stadium as the football team gets ready for the maroon and gold game. Chandler Volkswinkle has more in this Bobcat update.
The Bobcat football team has two scrimmages already behind them this spring. The scrimmages have given the team a chance to improve on offense and defense.
One of the main goals we stressed on this year is takeaway, getting the ball back from the offense. Working on physicality, that's been a major point. And getting off the field on third downs, that's been the three major points for defense this spring.
Definitely getting more of a balanced look on offense with the run and pass game. And just improving on fundamentals.
Spring practice has also given the team a chance to recognize some standout players.
I think Stedman Mayberry has had a big impact this spring so far. Stepping in for the running backs, with Rob Lowe injured. He's come back and Stedman's made a big impact, and then Chris Nuttall's come back as well and made a huge impact.
Though Jones and Mims will be on opposing sides of the ball this Saturday, there is one thing the two agree on.
Some receivers have stepped up, some running backs, so I mean, we look like we're going to be pretty good for next year.
Right now, we look pretty good.
The maroon and gold game is scheduled for April 4th at 1 p.m. The game will be open to the public and admission is free. Tailgating is encouraged. There will be a fun zone for kids, and stick around after the game for autographs from your favorite players. For Bobcat Update, I'm Chandler Voswinkle.
George's on the first floor of the LBJ Student Center has plenty of fun games to offer Texas State students for relaxing in between classes. From watching a game on the big screen to playing billiards with a friend, they can bring their own games to enjoy with friends or take advantage of George's shuffleboard, darts, ping pong, or Xbox, all free of charge.
According to the Guinness Book of World Records, the oldest person in the world now lives in Camden, Arkansas. Gertrude Weaver is 116 years old. She was born in 1898 near Texarkana, Arkansas. Gertrude spent most of her life as a housekeeper, a wife, and mother of four children. She has outlived three of her children, but her son, 93-year-old Joe, still visits her regularly. For her, the secret to long life is hard work and a loving God. Can you imagine living to 116 years old?
That would be amazing if I ever get to that point. And that will do it for Bobcat Update this week. Thanks for joining us.